Foreign engineering. Team foreign engineering. Okay. That time of 30 seconds. Good.
My name is Caleb Hughes.
My name is Paul Frank.
My name is Hunter Dalton.
We're foreign engineering, and we're here to tell you about our compound machine.
First off, our design brief. Our project name was Power to Most Power. Our client company, foreign engineering, the target consumer was the American people and the president. The lead engineers were us three. The problem statement was to have a team of 2 to 3 to build a compound machine that could lift a 1 kilogram, 12 inches in 30 seconds. The design statement was to a compound machine that has a pulley system, a wheel and axle, and a gear system. And some criteria and constraints, the project was timed at 2 weeks.
Yeah, that didn't happen.
Our brainstorming evidence, so here's a picture of our separate gear system. Initially, we kind of worked as we went. We saw what worked, we saw what didn't work. And over the course of the whole project, our build changed a lot from what our initial idea was to what we ended up with. So initially, we wanted to get a screw, a lever, wheel and axle, pulley system, all four of those in there. But we realized that having the screw and the lever, it wouldn't let us maximize our AMA and how much work we're actually putting into the machine. So as we kept working, we started developing a separate gear system, which Hunter developed. And the first model of it we had, it had a lot of torque with essentially no speed. It had too much speed and no torque. So it was taking way too long to lift up the kilogram. So we changed it around a little bit, kind of reversed it, and which gave us more torque and more speed. Here's our decision matrix. So we had the lever and the screw design, which didn't really cost that much. It was pretty, pretty light. But in the end game, it wasn't really working as we hoped it would. So then we moved to more of a screw and pulley setup. But as we kept working, the screw, we tried to use tread and stuff, and it just, it wouldn't give us enough time to lift the kilogram. So then we went to the separate gear system combined with the pulley, and that turned out to be the best out of the three options.
Here's the video we made.
So here in the video, we kind of zoom in on the separate gear system with the wheel and axle as the cranks and throughout there, and then we ended up having a movable pulley on there. It was tied up at the top, running under the pulley.
And here's all of our results. So first, our pulley system had a ideal mechanical advantage of 2, and our wheel and axle had a 5.38. Then our total IMA was 7.38, and our AMA actually ended up being 9.81, unexpectedly. Our efficiency was 132.9%, and the gear ratios were combined were 1.96. And then the weight ended up being 2.5 kilograms.
Any questions?
All right. Go ahead.
I'm Tommy.
I'm Ethan.
And we are Passion.
How's it go back down?
It doesn't go back down. Don't.
Or got tangled. Oh.
Yeah.
Go.
Tommy.
I'm Ethan.
And we are Passione. We did a big wheel from Spider-Man as our machine. It cost 298 million yen. Our design brief. Our client company is the federal government. The target consumer is Obamacare. And their problem is they need to lift bodies out of a pit so they can move them somewhere else. Some of the design constraints were we had 2 weeks to do this. And it had to meet some measurement requirements. Yeah.
So this is our brainstorming. What we want to do is have a very high gear ratio at the start for the end workout because it's breaking the machine. It's too fast. Yeah, we were going to add a lever on through that, but it didn't really change much, so we got rid of that. So it's dead weight. So we had a high amount of pulleys on it that helped lift the weight a lot easier. This is our design. We tried to do the real maximum pulleys. That was our highest score, that's where we went with this there, but some of our other ones were just a wheel and pulley, just a lever with on there, with on gears, and that worked, but it wasn't as fast. We had the wheel and the lever, that wasn't that good, so it didn't have the pulley. Yeah. It had a pulley, but it had enough tackle on it, so it couldn't lift that much, and we had the incline plane and pulley. That was just bad, there's a lot of friction for that.
Here are some pictures of our machine. We have a video here. As you can see, it lifts up the weight, the bodies. Here are some of our calculations. So we had an IMA of 17, but we only had an AMA of 3.5. And we think that's because of the string we used. It had a lot of friction. Our gear ratio was 0.43, which made it turn faster. And where we got a lot of our IMA from were our supporting strings and our pulley system.
All right.
All right. Caden.
Dillon.
Kenny.
We are Monostairs Incorporated.
Monostairs Incorporated. All
right.
Oh, up 1 foot. Did you make it?
Yeah, it went past the foot.
What happened there? Okay, all right, good.
All right, I'm Caden Ziegler.
Kenny Flory.
I'm Dylan Smith.
We're here to present to you our new invention called Slack-A-Lackin. So our target is a few people who happen to buy popcorn. And you know, our client is What's Poppin'. So have you ever found yourself in the difficult situation of you get home and you're too lazy to lift that heavy bowl of popcorn up to the microwave? Well, now you can just plaster this new invention right on top and just roll it and wheel it right up in there. And roll it right back down too after you're done dropping. Some of our criteria is we had 2 weeks to do this. We had to at least lift the your thing about 1 foot. It can go higher depending on how long your string is. And couple other measurement in there.
Alright, here are the sketches. This is the top view, the front view, and the side view. And this was from our first brainstorming idea, our final brainstorming idea.
We had done actually two different types before this, but we only have two up there. At first we tried to go gear to a screw to a pulley, but we realized it would take like 5 minutes to get a foot off the ground. And then the second one, we did the gears backwards, so we actually had negative AMMA rather than positive.
Some math, the wheel and axle AMMA is 1.9. The pulley AMMA is 2, gear ratio 2.8, overall AMMA 3.9, and overall AMMA 3.02. Some photos from just different views of the machine to show everything.
Very interesting video. And fun fact, like not even 3 seconds after doing this, the rope that was holding the weight kind of snapped. So that was. And that's it.
That's it. Ready?
All right.
I'm Tanner.
I'm Emma.
You're Tini.
Okay. Let's do a mechanism. We got a lever. Uh-oh, no. Uh-oh, so you have to have a ruler there too.
Oh, come on.
All right, let's do it again.
All right.
So, like, from here?
No, from the bottom, just from the bottom. There you go.
All right, so I'm Tanner, and that's Emma. Yeah. And we're going to go again and put our gears back in place.
Because
it slid off because it hit there. There, trial and error, you know? No, I mean, I told it was too hard.
Okay.
The
12 inches. All right. You got it. Right.
All right. So I'm Tanner.
I'm not.
And this is our pom pom machine.
Our client was our class, and then our target consumer was fishermen, because we were gonna aid into the lifting of a catfish onto a boat, and we were the lead engineers. And our design statement was that we had to lift a 1 kilogram weight within 30 seconds over a foot. Then our criteria was we had about 2 weeks, and we had to use at least 3 different mechanisms.
So we just had a couple of sketches of like original ideas. We went through a couple of them. Our first design here, we were gonna use a screw, a couple pulleys, and then a wheel and axle, but they didn't really work out because screws aren't that ideal for lifting weights. And then our second idea, it was basically use a series of gears into, I believe it was lever, and then that did something with pulleys. And this last one was the one that we actually used. We used gears into a pulley system that then lifted a lever. And that's just our lever system, our pulley system, which there's actually 6 pulleys, it takes a little bit, but like it still does make it there in 30 seconds. So we're like right at the cusp, but I think we hit like 28 seconds when we were testing it there. And then just a couple of quick things. Our IMAs for our lever was 1. Our pulleys was 5 because we had 5 supporting strings. Our overall IMA was 6. Our overall AMMA was 6.13. Our gear ratio is 1, so really the only reason that you could lift this and have an AMMA of 6 was due to the pulleys completely, because our gears was 1 and our levers was 1. So, yeah.
So you had an efficiency of over like 100%? Well, you had a, I don't know, your gear ratio is 1. Your AMMA is bigger than your IMA, huh?
Yeah, barely. I don't know why. It just
interesting.
Works.
Okay.
Yep.
That's it. Okay. Introduce yourselves.
Cody.
Jack.
Team.
The Final Frontier.
The Final Frontier.
Yeah.
It was already broken out.
No, it wasn't. No, it wasn't.
I was trying to think about it.
Ta-da.
All right. Okay.
Okay, I'm Cody.
I'm Jack.
We're the Final Frontier Corporation. We've come up with the Crank and Lift 2160.
So our client company was the Urbandale Library. Our consumer was any librarians that worked there. And the basic idea is that they're having trouble lifting up some books through really high shelves, and this is going to help them get it up there since some of the books are really heavy. And this machine takes up a fairly little surface area because the base is so small, so they can easily use it with their library-like book carts. And we had to get it so it could lift the book at least 12 feet in under 30 seconds, and we had 2 weeks to make the machine with an AMA of at least 12 inches, sorry.
Okay, so based off of our final design, this is our sort of sketch in our engineering notebook. And so we have a pulley system that you spin a wheel and axle to turn the gears that eventually lifts the book all the way up the 12 inches it needs to go. And then we had to make a support for it because the tower would lean over and it looked like it might snap. So we built a small support that as soon as we put that on, it doesn't lean or bend anymore.
So we had a lot of ideas, very ridiculous names, because that's how we do things. And the first was the Hell Roller 7800, which I realized would not work after realizing it was just a wheel and axle pulling a string up an inclined plane, which only had two machines, which we needed at least three. And then pulleys on pulleys was basically just a really, really long block and tackle that ended up taking way too long to do, even with three machines, so we couldn't use that one. And the gearbox launcher was a stupid idea that probably couldn't happen, which was basically getting a gear system so crazy that it just shot the weight up into the air, and then it hopefully didn't kill anybody on its way back down, which didn't seem perfectly safe, so we didn't do that one. And the one we decided on was the Crank and Lift 2160, which is the one that used gears to turn a wheel and axle to operate a pulley to pull it upwards safely. And the Sky High Zag-Zig was basically a bunch of pulleys and a zigzag thing going up two supports, but it took too long for the weight to go back and forth between them, even though it was really easy to pull it. So we couldn't use that one.
Okay, and then this is our video of it working. And you really only need to use one hand because it's not that hard to lift. But, and then once you get it up there, the machine will go back down pretty smoothly in order to load up the next book.
And the ideal mechanical advantage of our pulley was three due to the number of supporting strings. The ideal mechanical advantage of the wheel and axle was 1.11 for the input of the first wheel and axle, and then 2.16 for the wheel and axle that actually drove the pulley. And the total actual mechanical advantage of the machine was 6.27, and our gear ratio was 3/7, and it weighed 3.4 pounds.
All right.
I'm Taylor.
I'm Michael.
I'm Scott.
Okay. Oh, yeah. And this is Team
SMT.
Yeah, Corp.
All right.
Gonna make it in 30 seconds.
28 seconds.
Ooh.
It's pretty close.
Thank you.
So, planning company is SMT. Guess what it stands for? Our target consumer was for lightweight construction projects all around. And so, our problem was a ladder is too tall for lazy construction workers to come to the bottom to grab nails. So they decided to build a compound machine so they could lift their small buckets of nails. And we had to complete this project in under 2 weeks, well, around 2 weeks, and we had to lift a 1 kilogram mass, 12 inches.
All right, so these are our first couple sketches, and the first one was what we ended up kind of doing with the gearbox and the top with the wheel connected to the gearbox, and then the pulley is a movable pulley underneath the wheel. And then the bottom one was what we were trying to do at the beginning, and when we had the gears below the pulley was not like, there was too much strain on the gearbox or whatever. We had to end up switching our gearbox and redesigning our gearbox just in general at the beginning because there was too much torque for it to work, and it ended up having too much strain on the string and the pulleys. So we ended up going with the top one, but those were our two original designs.
So for our original designs, we had the wheel and axle with the gears and the pulley, which is what we ended up doing because it had the best ammo overall and it was the easiest to like apply and build. Our like runner-up idea that we actually spent a week building was an inclined plane with that was driven. The weight was pulled up by a block and tackle attached to a wheel and axle at the base. And we figured out it just wasn't really going to work, and we weren't getting enough advantage out of the plane to be worth it. So we kind of scrapped that and did our first idea. And then the other one was connected to a screw, which wouldn't work because of time constraint. And then same with the other screws and gear idea.
So we did a video of our pilot works, and it's like under 30 seconds, around like 28.57, and the gears is much better because we have like a big gear ratio to small, which is like speed but like less torque, and then we have to like switch it up so that we have a small gear ratio to a bigger one so that it makes so that has more torque.
Yeah, that video was before we changed the gear ratio.
For our calculations, our pulley system is 3, and our wheel axle is 3.33. The total IMA of the machine is 9.99. The AMA of the machine is 6.54. The efficiency is 65%. The gear ratio is 5, and the overall cost is 1,908,000 dollars.
All right, that's it.
All right. Introduce yourself.
Hi, I'm Alec.
I'm Ben.
I'm Dillon.
And you're
Basla.
Basla. Who's holding this?
I got it.
This is the biggest machine coming in at just under $3 million.
Wow. That's the first time that has happened.
Karma.
Oh my. It was shaking too much.
Well,
okay, you're gonna,
this
you're
actually gonna snapped off this time. So that's not fun.
That didn't happen the first, like...
Ben, that's your knot that failed. Come on, man. We'll leave that.
Ben.
Alec.
Dylan.
We're Besla.
Honestly, I wouldn't be surprised.
There we go.
Okay.
So, our engineering firm is Besla.
machine name is the device that picks up coconuts. We turned it into an acronym over there.
Our client was SpaceX, and they wanted to assist the people that were coming back from the Mars colony. They found out that when people come back from being in low gravity environments for a long time, they have severe muscle deterioration, and they couldn't lift the 1 kilogram coconuts that they were given for food. So the project was to make a lift that will not require very much force to lift the coconuts, and the criteria and constraints are in a very small font at the bottom.
What is gravity on Mars?
It's lower.
It's lower?
It's lower than Earth.
Is it?
Yeah.
Okay. You hope so.
So some of our different brainstorms. We used to have like this little machine right here, which was a stopper, but
you broke it.
It got so so this one right here is pretty much what we did. It was just basically just a big tower that was going to lift it with a pulley at the top, and then just gears to assist it. I don't know which one that was. I didn't draw that.
That was our attempt to lift it up an inclined plane.
We were going to have a pulley system that lifts up an inclined plane. Here's our precision matrix. So you can see we had two designs that we actually built. The big to small one had like a small input going into a large gear, which would go to a smaller gear that would actually lift the waste, but we found out that it required too much force to be feasible, and then we had the one that we actually made that goes into a bigger gear to a slightly less small gear that actually works.
So here's our design. We eventually settled on using a very, very large gear with a wheel and axle, a large wheel and a small gear at the end of it. As a wheel and axle, we connected it to a gear system that incrementally stepped up the gear size until we had the largest size. This was to reduce the amount of weight that was on each individual gear. When we just put a small gear with a large gear, we found that the small gear just had a tendency to snap off. So we had to put an increment gear in there just to avoid that. And then the large gear connects to a pulley system, which goes up to the top, back down, connects to the weight, and pulls the weight up when you turn the wheel.
So the wheel and axle has an IMO of about 3.3. The gear system has a gear ratio of 84 to 6 or 7 to 3. The pulley has an IMO of 1.
We had a stopping mechanism that's no longer functional due to the removal of the stocking mechanism.
Yeah. It was our weighty demonstration.
And a fun thing about this is that it actually had so much weight back up a little bit, raise it another half inch off the ground before actually setting it back down.
Alright. For calculations, the effort distance was 260 inches, and the distance resistance is 12, which gives us an IMO of about 22. The effort force is 0.8412 newtons. The resistance is 9.81 newtons, which gives us an AMO of 11.7 and an efficiency of about 53%.
Okay. Okay, go on.
Okay, I'm Robbie Rice.
I'm Varun Veppa, and this is the Curse Breaker.
Curse Breaker.
All right, we got our 30 seconds.
Yeah.
I hope so. Action.
Okay, I'm Robby Rice.
I'm Varun Beppa. And this is the Curse Breaker. It's the design brief.
What was that?
It's a link to our design brief.
Okay, so our client company is the Kingdom of Terabithia.
Yeah. Our target consumer was the King of Terabithia, King Drowned.
And the engineers were us of Vice Industries.
So the problem was, King Drowned of Terabithia was cursed by a dark wizard, and he couldn't lift any kilograms. And this is important because Terabithia's biggest export is gram weights, which is a huge problem, so he contacted us to fix it.
So our design statement was that Vice Industries will build a complex machine made of simple machines that will hopefully cleverly relieve King Drowman of this curse.
So this is our evidence of brainstorming. Obviously there was a lot of thought, and there were pulleys and strings and wheels and axles, all simple machines that we all know and love.
This is our decision matrix. We kind of flipped it. Instead of going the lowest is the best, we did the highest is the best, so we kind of flipped the scale around. But this is our design, that one. Yeah.
Called design three.
Yep, okay. Design
three, yep.
So,
creative.
Obviously, these are the simple machines that we use. They're machines, and they're simple. Two constraints for being a simple machine. We used a wheel and axle, another wheel and axle, a gear system, and a movable pulley. Would you guys like to see the video again, because I've already shown it to you?
Yes.
Yeah.
Again?
Yeah.
Okay. This is the video for the machine.
Calculations.
Thank you for watching.
What was your mechanical damage?
Two.
You don't remember?
No.
It was something.
It was a number.
11?
6.7.
Total.
The ammo
is 6.7.
The ammo is 6.7, huh? Okay. All right. Any questions?
Tommy? Any questions? Kenny?
Nice job.
Wait, Caleb has questions.
Where is VK Industries located in Italy?
Look, it's true, I never grew up with siblings. I was an only child.
Okay.
And so the fact that I met Robby at engineering school and we could build a company from the ground up, and you make fun of us here? I won't take this.
Hey.
Thank you for...
Hold on, I gotta zoom in to get your anger.
What's your current marital status?
My wife hasn't looked at me for 2 years.
Okay.